Jay, I'm out here at the range today with a Smith and Wesson Model 686. This is the stainless steel version of the 586. Smith designates the stainlesses with that number 6. 7 shot, so some call this the 686 plus, 6 shots being the non plus. Wow. As you know, I love revolvers. If you watch my videos, you know that for sure, and you know that in my opinion, they're just none better than the Smith. Probably part of that's the history. Well, maybe a lot of that is the history. Just a great feeling revolver. You just know when you're holding Smith and Wesson, or at least I do, revolvers, you're holding quality. Also that little piece of history. Now, my favorite revolver, and I've shared this in several videos with you, is the Model 19. Not necessarily my favorite carry revolver, but it is my favorite. The history with it I love, and just the beauty of the revolver. So before I go on with this one, let me just show you that Model 19 in comparison. And what I want you to note is the bulky heaviness of this one, 357 Magnum, as opposed to the little lighter Model 19. Okay, hang tight a minute, let me bring up the 19. All right, y'all, my favorite, the Model 19. Now we're gonna get right back to the 686. A lot of its history and just the beauty of this gun. Now this is a 357 Magnum also. If you wanna know some of the history, go over to my review of this. This gun, yes, it's 357 Magnum, but for me, I practice mostly with plus P's with it. And then if I'm gonna carry it around the ranch, I'm gonna put in the Magnum rounds. This gun is a little, just overall lighter action, so I don't think it handles the abuse of the 357 Magnum just pounding out here at the range. But if you want a gun that will handle that abuse, all right, back to the 686. Now this gun at 40 ounces, it's beefed up internally. It will handle all the abuse you want to put through it with the 357 Magnum. 686 developed in 1980. This is a 4-inch barrel. You can get it 2.5 all the way up to 6-inch barrel. 4 is my favorite. 3, like for the Model 60, is my favorite. But this 4 is carryable, not bad at all. To carry this, I carry it in a Galco under the left shoulder holster. Works perfectly in that manner. So from a shootability standpoint, 4-inch barrel, ideal. Let's look at the sights. Very easy to sight, but it has that rectangular side at the back that you can put that little red side at the front right in. Easy to side in. Let's look at the trigger. Now again, we're unloaded. Trigger action with this. Double action, single action. The double action, very smooth, 10 to 11 pounds. Now that's what you want. If you're going to carry it hammer down, double action, fully loaded, no problem. You got that 10 to 11 pound pull, first pull, single. Now you see what happens, like with every revolver, hairpin trigger. And that 3 to 4 pound, if that. But that trigger, single action, out here is really fun. And that's what I shoot mostly when I get out at the ranch. Carry it hammer down, but boy, if I've got a 40, 50 yard shot out there, the little varmint, nothing like coming back with that single action, putting the sight right on it, tap it, and that sight never moves. All right, let's see how this gun shoots. All right, this first shooting here, I've got 3 rounds in it. The first one that I want to shoot double action, 38 special. The second one, 38 plus P. The third one, the 357 Magnum. So let's see how these look comparatively, especially with muzzle rise and how they feel. So first shot is going to be right out there. That's the 38 special. Let's go with the plus P. Now let's go with the Magnum. Boy, does it handle that nicely. Wow. I think you could see muzzle rise increased a little as we went along. 38 special, 38 plus P felt the same. Magnum a little more, but boy, does this gun handle that Magnum round nicely. Let's go ahead and load up with Magnums now. All right, this time, better keep my finger off that till I'm ready to shoot. See if we can put it right through that little hole. These are Magnums. Smith & Wesson's Model 686. If you want the real deal with a Magnum, this is the real deal. Hey, thanks for viewing us here at Real Guys Reviews, y'all. We appreciate it. Hope to see you around.